starting in verse 14.
To be around with, and I tell you what, you start praying them out,
you better make sure that your life is in order, and you better make sure that there is nothing out of order in your life.
Come on, sister.
Amen. Amen. Yeah. Come on.
Amen. Amen. Because you know what? Every demon you cast out, every demon that is rebuked, if your household and your heart is not right where it's supposed to be with God, those demons go out, bring more back in seven times stronger than what you got out to start with. So you think it was rough dealing with the one or the two, wait until it goes back and gets seven more that's stronger and bigger and better and worse than what you sent out. It ain't nothing to play with. I see advertised on TV this paranormal stuff, and I can't remember the names of the movies. I ain't never watched them, have no desire to. But it's something about where houses are haunted and all this stuff. And I've seen on the commercials where somebody was jerked out of a bed or whatever. I don't know how real it is on that movie. It's supposed to be real. But anyway, demons can do that.
Amen.
I'm not saying those movies are real. I don't know. I have no clue. Don't really care. But I am saying that demons has the power to do crazy things. And believe me, there's nothing more than they like than messing with a Christian or somebody that says they're a Christian. Because you know what? If you're already living for Satan, why do they need to mess with the lost?
Right.
Why do they need to mess with them? Because they're already going to hell. So the only ones that the demons really want is the ones of us that says we are Christian.
Amen.
And actually live it. Mm-hmm. Those are the ones that the demons want. So let me tell you, if you're walking around here and everything in your life is all hunky-dory and just fine, and you're not going through any problems at all, right here's where you need to be.
Come on. Amen.
Preach.
Because when your life is rosy and your life is calm and you don't have a worry and a care at all, then that means that the demons are not worried about you. Satan's not worried about you.
Absolutely.
Because he's already got
you.
That's right. When you are on a daily struggle, and it seems like every which way you turn, that you're up against the wall and getting pushed there more and more and more. Our son lost his job Friday over something so very, very stupidly ignorant. And I've never heard of him such a thing. He comes in, and I told him, I'm sorry to hear this. You know what he tells me? He says, it lets me know that everything's all right. He says, I'm where God wants me to be. And he said, because Satan is a fighting, and Satan's a ripping, and Satan's trying to put me against the wall. He says, and that just lets me know that I'm doing exactly what God. All right. And I'm like, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
I mean, you know, it did hurt me, you know, to know how wrongly he had been done. It hurt me. And I was aggravated. I was angry at this company for doing that to him. And he comes in, he's like, it's okay. I'm just doing what, I know I'm doing what God wants me to do. So, anyways, is your mobile a mountain? Or is your little anthill a mountain to you? Sometimes we can look at the smallest of things and we're really, really bothered by it.